I hope I tied this properly. I don't think I even tied it, actually. Alright, boom. Welcome back to the channel. If it's your first time, welcome to the channel. My name's Shinobi. I'm an artist based in Michigan. And today, I'm just going to be doing a portrait in acrylics. I haven't done acrylics in a very long time, and this is kind of just, it's meant to be relaxing, it's meant to be refreshing and just taking it easy, you know what I mean? Nothing too serious. It's not really a composition. Normally I sketch out my compositions beforehand, but I don't think I'm going to do that this time around. Who am I going to be painting? I am going to be painting somewhere right there in this general vicinity. This is my friend. She doesn't know about this. I asked for volunteers on my Instagram. I do that sometimes, and she was one of the few people. Well, not few, many people. Not too many people. A little bit. Few people. Let's just say few people. One of the few people that, you know, put their faces down. And so today I'm just gonna paint her, cause, well, she'd be pissed if I paint someone else before her. So, you know, I'm gonna just get out of the way. But yeah, I'm not exactly going a la prima, but I am going a la prima. I'm probably gonna do a base painting still, just because, you know, I want to sort out all my planes first before I go in with color. But because there's acrylics, I'm gonna do it all in the same day, and I don't have to wait for it to dry. As always, enough talking, let's get into the painting. Showtime. Real quick, we are gonna go into my underpainting slash underdrawing. We're gonna go through this real quick. This is just practice. We don't really want to waste too much time. I can do a video of my drawing process and do a bit of a tutorial if you guys want that. But this is really just therapeutic for me, because, you know, I do this so often that I kind of get into the flow state. There's only like that first 5 minutes of nervousness usually. And then after that, you kind of just settle in and you know what you're doing. And then you can take a deep breath. I'm just going to be using acrylics. Well, these ones I got from class, I think. I'm not really sure. I'm pretty sure I didn't buy these, because I don't really buy acrylics. I haven't bought them since I was 16. But yeah, if you care about the brand, that's Grumbacker. I think that's how you would pronounce it. Liquitex. And the rest of them are Liquitex, so I'm just going to be mixing brands really at this point, because who cares? So yeah, but that said, it's kind of a limited palette. Can't really get, I don't have my yellow ochres and that. Although I could, I've got a palette with those in there, so I could put that out, but I think I'm gonna go with simple colors today. You know, maybe not even something too realistic. I'm gonna use green for my base to like get my darks out there. And yeah, I'm gonna be using pretty much these colors. I don't think I'm gonna really use purple. Acrylics don't really spread that much. And you know, you can't just keep adding water. But also, that said, it's my first time using this, but we got these in class, some extenders. This is some gloss extender, GAC 500 golden acrylics, I think. Also a fluid matte medium. I think I'm gonna use the gloss one first, I think. I don't know, I could do some research, but again, I like to learn on the floor. So yeah, let's get into that. I'll mix some skin tones real quick. You can see the dark green I used for the underpainting there. I kind of layer over this really, and I try and secure the eyebrows before I start with anything else. Honestly, this is quite different from like what my acrylic process used to be, or what I thought it was. Like, I apparently now paint the same way I paint with oils, more or less. Apart from the whole underpainting, it's pretty much like I'm glazing over each surface with like a new color. So I'm not deciding on the final color the moment I place my brush on it. I'm almost mixing on the cardboard. Speaking of cardboard, I used to paint on cardboard a lot, you know. I kind of forgot to mention this in the intro, but I'll show you guys a few more clips of previous works of me painting on cardboard. I think I have enough footage to probably do a whole process video. Maybe not on one painting, a few paintings together maybe. But this is High and Mighty, part of a series I did last year. And cardboard is a pretty versatile material. You just have to prime it with clear coat primer. I didn't use any for this one because this is acrylics, but yeah, I can definitely talk more on that for you guys in another video. Just let me know down below.
I think that's pretty much it for this one. Like I said, it's meant to be like a therapy kind of piece. Not really therapy, it's meant to be just relaxing, you know what I mean? So I didn't really have a plan for it. So yeah, and I don't really like to just paint portraits for the sake of painting portraits. Like once I feel like I'm done with it, I can just kind of stop anywhere. And I've been thinking about how I could like push this, you know, possibly further, but I've been kind of drawing blanks, so you know, I'm just gonna put a hold on it for a while. I'm not too fussed about it. I might keep it in the corner, something like that. But in the meantime, I'm pretty sure you might have seen me setting these up in the background. I'm hoping that one's gonna be a commission, you know, a few more days and I'll be sure. And on the right there, I think I'm just gonna do one of my compositions from my sketchbook on here. It's called Procrastination. Yeah, man. Like I said again, this is my friend Kennedy, one of my best friends in the US, and yeah, she's a beautiful woman, but this was just a portrait study, just for fun. And I hope in this video I kind of made sure to stress the point of practice. And anyways, yeah, that's that. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you leave a like and comment down below. You know, what do you want to see me make next? What kind of videos are you interested in? And if you want to support the channel, make sure to grab one of my hoodies from my website. I got like three of them. I got a few good designs on there, so check them out. I'm kind of waiting on making more designs. I want to get these ones out first, you know what I mean? Hoodies, get merch, get prints, all on my website, shinobi.com. And yeah, much love, all of that. Showtime. Peace.